I have a lot of pine boards from an old bed. They are perfect for this project. Now, let's cut them to width on the table saw. The sides are about 30 centimeters. The top and bottom are 25 centimeters. I wanted to join the pieces with butt joints. My table saw broke down, so I had to make the joints with a circular saw and a speed square. I did some tests, and after a while I kind of got the hang of it. Next, to make the grooves for the back panel. The panel is just a thin MDF piece from an old IKEA bookcase. I decided to reinforce the butt joints with dowels. Next, to make the front panel. I used dowels to join the boards. The dowels basically keep the pieces from sliding around while glued up. Here I convert a piece of plexiglass into a huge sanding block. And now I can sand the front edge flat. To flatten the front panel, I first did some cross-grain planing. Then I did some finishing passes parallel to the grain. Of course, you can avoid all the trouble and buy a ready-made panel. Flat enough for me. Time to cut the front door of the cabinet. At this point, I filled all the imperfections. I didn't glue the front panel so it can expand and contract freely. This will be a French cleat system, so you can hang the cabinet on the wall. And that's the door handle. To install the hinges, I temporarily clamped the door in place. The door will stay closed with a rare earth magnet and a screw. The magnet is glued in place with some 5-minute epoxy. You can't have a first aid kit without a cross, so let's create one. This is latex paint. Finally, I applied 3 coats of clear water-based satin varnish. I lightly sanded between coats with 220. And project done. Here's the French cleat for hanging it on the wall. You can use the hangers to hang small tools. That narrow shelf is cool. Overall, I think a cabinet like this can be really useful, especially in a woodworking shop. Anyway, I hope you found this project useful, because that was it. See you soon with a new project video.